So in this video, I'll talk about the Thevenin theorem a little bit more. The Thevenin theorem says that we can take any linear circuit element and represent it by a very simple mathematical model. So let's try doing this by working a rather complicated example. I say complicated because it's only complicated when we write the original version of the circuit. It's not so complicated when we write the Thevenin mathematical model. So let's say that we've got a kind of an unusual looking circuit with the voltage source turned upside down. We have a 20 ohm resistor, we have an 80 ohm resistor, a 16 ohm resistor, and two nodes. So we could assume that we have a kind of a black box circuit, and I know from the Thevenin theorem that as long as we have a bunch of linear circuit elements inside the black box, then the entire contents of the black box can be represented by a mathematical model that is a lot simpler. I can find a Thevenin equivalent voltage source and a Thevenin equivalent resistance. And if I'm outside the black box doing any kind of measurement on these two terminals, I won't be able to tell the difference between my simple Thevenin equivalent circuit and the original more complicated circuit. All right, now that's only if you're standing outside the box. If you're inside the box, obviously things are different. For example, inside the box here on the left, I've got a lot of resistors and a 20 volt source. This 20 volt source has to push current through all these resistors. So if I were to ask a question like, how much power is this 20 volt source supplying? And how does that power compare with the Thevenin equivalent source? I wouldn't get the same answer because the Thevenin equivalent source is going to be more efficient if I were to actually build it, and they would perform the same if you're standing outside the box, but inside the box, the 20 volt source is going to burn up more power because we've got extra resistors. But if you're outside the box, everything's going to look the same. So let's discuss how we can find this mathematical model of the more complicated source. How do you do it? So outside the box, I can take measurements. For example, I can measure the voltage, I can measure the current, or I could hook a test resistor to the circuit and change the resistance and take various measurements. But it turns out that you don't have to do very complicated measurements in order to find the Thevenin equivalent. In order to find the VTH, all you need to do is measure the voltage without anything attached to it at all. All right, so we're going to assume that there's no load or anything like that attached to the circuit. Without any load attached, we just need to find V. How would we do that? So in this circuit, if there's no load attached, meaning there's no resistor attached over here, then there's no current flowing through the 16 ohm resistor. If I want to know what the voltage V is, let me draw this little circuit fragment. We have an 80 ohm resistor, but you see without any current flowing through the 16 ohm resistor, there's no voltage drop across the 16 ohm resistor. So the voltage here at this node is the same as the voltage here because V equals IR and the current I equals zero. Therefore, the voltage drop is zero. So this voltage equals this voltage. Let's find this voltage because there's no current flowing here. Let's find the voltage across the 80 ohm resistor. I'm going to use voltage division. Well, let's call this voltage difference V because in fact it's the same voltage difference that appears at these two terminals given that there's no current through the 16 ohm resistor. So V is minus 20 because the source is turned upside down, and then 80 over 80 plus 20. So this is negative 20 times 8 over 10 or minus 16 volts. Therefore, VTH equals minus 16 volts. All right, now let's find the Thevenin equivalent resistance now. To find the Thevenin equivalent resistance, all we need to do is zero out our sources. In this case, we only have one source, the voltage source, and find the resistance measured between the terminals. In other words, I'm going to zero this source or turn it off. And if you turn off a voltage source, it means dialing down the voltage to zero into a short circuit. So we have 20 ohms here, we have 80 ohms here, 16 ohms here, and then our terminals. And I want to know the equivalent resistance looking back in this circuit. So if I look back in the circuit, what do I see? Well, I see 16 plus, and then I've got two branches here, 20 in parallel with 80 ohms. So that's 16 plus 16. 32 ohms. So this means that my Thevenin equivalent resistance is also going to be 32 ohms. All right, so what does all this mean? It means that if I were to build a circuit that has a 16-volt source turned upside down and a 32-ohm resistor, and I put it into a black box, and you can't see what's inside, you compare the performance of this circuit with the circuit that I drew that was more complicated, that had three different resistors, I won't be able to tell these circuits apart. Meaning, if I attach a resistor to the circuit at the outside terminals, and I start to vary that resistor, and I measure the voltage and the current through that resistor, it's not going to behave any differently than the circuit that's more complicated. All right, this is useful for a lot of things. It's useful for simplifying circuits. It's also useful for understanding how more complex circuits actually perform. And it's also useful for simplifying sources. If you enjoyed watching this video, then you might be interested in following our playlist and learning more about the fundamentals of electrical circuits.